I'd have to watch all of these.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
What's going on, guys? Today, I'll be teaching you how to paint in a Borderlands comic book style. I've received a lot of questions from the community about how I painted my Imperial Guard army in a Borderlands comic book style. So today, I'll be running through my process on how I paint flesh tones as part one of a four-part series on how to paint an Astra Militarum Volgrin. I find that using a bright mid-tone and working up to a just off-white highlight is perfect for this style of painting, as we go back through and add Vallejo Black ink once we are happy with our colours. Brush selection is pretty important for this style of painting, particularly when using the ink. I have found success with thin, longer brushes, as they allow me to reach into recesses and provide smooth, thin lines. I use a Tamiya modelling brush in a HF size for this part of the process. All right, before I lose my mind, let's get started. So, beginning with the layer of Deathclaw Brown. First base going down. Ready for it to dry. We'll be using Kilsurf Flesh to build up our layers. So, for this, we're sort of just mapping out where the light would fall most, and just really nice and thin layers. It's basically any of the raised areas we're sort of building up. I've probably even done this a little bit too thin.
Thank you. to use the heart. I'm using Flame on Flesh. And we'll just go through. And in the same motions that we've been doing before, making sure that we've got thin brush and a nice tip. We're going to go back through with our Vallejo Game Ink Black, and we'll start by just going through all of the recesses, and then we'll get to the fun part of adding our own details. Once I have finished painting the ink into the recesses of the model, I can now start to add my own details. The detail depends on what material I'm painting. For skin, I'm mimicking sinew and muscle, so the details I add are in lines that flow naturally along the arms.
You still have to clean it up, but for me at least, I found that if you're quick, you can patch it a little nicer.
Mistakes are just part of this process. I fix my mistakes by patching over the black ink I'm not happy with. I start with layers of the original undercoat until it's barely visible. Then I follow the same process as I outlined before. And there we have it. We've finished the skin tones in our model. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions or recommendations, please leave a comment and I'll get to them in the next video.